Hi my friends, it's Ro. Welcome back to my channel. Today, I'm going to tell you exactly how much money an inmate will need and what exactly they need to buy the very first week that they're in jail or prison. Contrary to popular belief, they are not issued every single thing that they need by the government or by the state, depending on if they're in federal prison or state prison. So if you're interested in learning how much money they need, the things that they need directly off of a commissary list, how much everything costs, then please keep watching. If you're new here, my name is Ro. My husband's on his 20th year of a life sentence where nobody was hurt. If you're interested in learning more about that, I will link a video all about it up there, but I don't want to waste too much time today. Let's just get right into this. A few years back, Adam sent me a commissary list, and I asked him recently, just within the last couple of days, if it was still up to date and relevant, and he said yes. So I'll pop a little picture of it right up there. Today, we're going to go through the exact items that he suggests for somebody to get or what they need for the very first week that they're inside. Excuse my eyes, I'm looking down at my computer. The first thing is a Timex Ironman wristwatch, and that is $37.95 off of the commissary. Of course, these are one-time commissary purchases when you first arrive, either at a new location and you lost all of that stuff, either in transit, they didn't move it with you, you weren't allowed to take it, or you're brand spanking new to prison. The next thing you'll need is a travel-sized alarm clock, and that sells on the commissary for $10. The next thing is, it's a Sony FM AM Walkman. Brings me back to my youth, but that sells for $49. The next is COS R10 headphones, and those sell for $36.40. Where he is, you need the headphones and the Walkman to listen to anything, including the TVs. You need your little headphones and you need to plug them into your radio, and then you tune into a station so you could hear the TV, which works out well for them because then they could hear the TVs once they're locked into their cells for the night. He gets locked in around 9:00 PM, which is kind of early for bedtime for grown men. He'll put in his earphones and he'll listen to whatever's on the TVs. We'll talk about how you get what you want to watch on the TVs at a different time because it's kind of interesting. Who has the remote controls? Who's not supposed to have the remote controls and gets them? We'll talk about it later. The next one is a master lock combination. That's a lot of words. It's just a lock for your locker where you keep all your belongings. And that one is $7 on the commissary. Then you need a calculator because you're doing a lot of math in there. And that was $10. Seriously though, you do, because you're calculating how many phone minutes you have left, because where he is, they're in 15 minute increments. How much money you owe somebody, how much money you need to put on your books because you need to go to commissary this week. So a calculator is extremely important, especially if you're not efficient at head math. Lord knows I'm not. The next one is a pocket dictionary, and this is $3.85. So is this necessary the first week? I mean, I wouldn't think so, but for him, he thinks this is necessary. So there's gotta be a reason why. The next one is an address book, and that sells for 75 cents. The next is shower shoes, and those sell for $3.50. If you go back and watch my video with Poochie, I'll link it up there. I apologize about the video quality of it. My Wi-Fi wasn't working and I didn't know it during the video. It looked fine on my end, but he talks all about shower shoes and how you cannot take a shower without those slides because, well, he says, in his words, he's like, nasty. The next one is a Gillette sensor razor, and then in parentheses he has a handle, so you're not buying the razor blade, you're buying the actual whole razor with the handle, and that sells for $6.05. The next is a locker mirror, which is handheld, so think about the mirror with the handle and the square at the top, I'm assuming, and that's $2.45. The next one is fingernail clippers, those are 45 cents. Then toenail clippers, which are 90 cents. I guess because your toes are bigger, they're double the price. I don't know. A hairbrush, which is $1.25. Safety scissors, which are $6.70. I'm so curious what those look like and how sharp they are. Then a coffee mug, which is $2.75. Microwavable bowls to cook, but also to store things, he said. That's $5.70. A gallon jug that you want to put your water or your ice in. That's $7.35. Damn. Plastic clothes hangers are $1.85. Boxers, and this is a pack of three, that's $32.85. Are you kidding me? I hope that's a typo. Jeez. See, this says boxers are $11.85. Oh, so yeah, so if you're getting three, wow. Jeez, that's robbery. Take you to Walmart and get them for you for $3. The next is ankle socks. Those are $13. He doesn't say how many. I don't know if that's for one pair, but again, that's price gouging. Athletic shoes, which are $65, and we're not talking top of the line Nikes. We're talking about, think of orthopedic, old school dollar store sneakers, and you're paying $65 for those. Next is sweatpants, and those are $31.50. Oh, think about the dollar store. You get sweatpants with a tapered bottom. They have off stitching. They probably have stitching that's coming apart. There always is something wrong with it. So let's say one leg is shorter than the other. These are the rejects of stuff that is repackaged and sold to them in the commissary because they are the rejects of society, sadly. But you're paying $31 for a pair of sweatpants that you could get at Walmart for probably $8, maybe less. $3 on sale? Jeez. Sweatshirt, which is also just a basic gray Walmart style sweatshirt, and that's $33.80. Think about that. I will very rarely pay that for a sweatshirt that's marked up because it's somebody's merch and that's how they're making their money. That's about what you pay, and they're paying this, or we're paying this if you think about it, for them to get a basic all gray oversized cotton sweatshirt. Wow. Mesh shorts are $37.70. Oh, I can't tell you the last time I bought mesh shorts for a guy, but I'm thinking, what, that's like $15, $20. Thermal tops, $15.90. I've gotten them at Old Navy for $3, just saying. Gym bag is $8.45. Not too bad, although I've gotten those for free at events like fitness competitions when I used to compete, but that's okay. Baseball cap is $4. Winter gloves are $7.40. I am shook. Literally shook. That is what you need the first week, one time, first time purchases, either when you move to a new location or when it's your very first day walking in the door. A lot of times people will take you under your wing if you're a good guy, if you don't have something in your reputation that precedes you getting to the place where you're going, because that spreads, then there'll be somebody who will take you under their wing. Usually it's somebody from the same location, the same city where you're from, this is federal, or the same race. So like, let's say I, God forbid, had to go, it would either be the New York, New Jersey crew, it would be the Italian crew. Somebody would take me under their wings. It's just how it is in there, and they would make sure I'm set up with stuff. Laundry would know first when people were coming in on the next bus, I guess, to issue state issue clothing or whatever, because it's a large system, but it's also a small system. So if it was people they knew, or people that had a good reputation, they would make up little welcome bags, I guess you would call them, for lack of a better term, but for them. So there would be maybe a toothbrush, a pair of socks, a pair of shower shoes, those kinds of things. So they are set up until their account is switched on, because that's all shut off while you're traveling, or it has to be set up when you're first getting there. So their account's turning on, they can get money on the books, and then they get issued a day where they can shop. So that could take a couple of weeks. Usually people are really good. I'm sure you have to pay the stuff back or give it back or whatnot. I'm not positive how that works. I'm sure it's different in different situations, with different people, with different reputations, with different friends, and so on and so forth. I added all of that together because Adam didn't, and I am floored. When it hurts like this, that is $529.10, and that is just for very minimal clothing and first time things. That does not include any hygiene products, that does not include any food, and we'll get into that in a future video. I just don't want to make this one too long, but I remember when I first got back in touch with him, a friend whose boyfriend was also inside was like, when he moves, because he moved 9 months after we got back in touch, you should probably put a couple hundred dollars on his books. And I was like, what? Why? And she explained to me that it costs a lot of money to move. And I was like, why? And then going through this stuff, now I understand, and I'm here to tell you that's why. This is almost $600 just on basic stuff that does not include, like I said, hygiene, toothpaste, toothbrush, hair gel, deodorant, any of that, or food to get you through, because you're only getting 3 small meals a day issued. Stay tuned for those other videos coming very soon. I came back to add this. I forgot this part. For you guys, I commented about my shirt having a hole in it. It's a crazy story about how that shirt got ripped. It just wound up being in a perfect spot that I could still wear it. But I had taken a family vacation to California, and my niece was in the water on the beach. Why I was wearing a turtleneck to the beach, because you cannot cover your body enough to not get wrinkles when you get into your 40s. So anyway, all of a sudden she starts splashing around in the water and she's like, shark, shark. So I went to go help her and thank God I got her out of the water, but a shark attacked my shirt and made a huge hole in the front of it. Thank God I got us both out to safety. They came and found me. They gave me a hero award. I saved everybody on the beach. It was fantastic and I saved that shirt as a souvenir. So yeah, I know, my shirt has a hole in it. I actually bought it like that for $3 on a clearance rack because I liked it. And if you don't, thank God it's on my body and not yours. Peace. If you're interested in an itemized breakdown long list of everything somebody inside needs, from soup to nuts, not literally soup to nuts, it's something we say in Italian because we start our meals with soup and we end our meals with nuts and we have about 6 courses in between, not kidding, but everything that you could possibly imagine, including haircuts and having somebody personal train you and taking courses and all that stuff, just watch that video up there and make sure you subscribe. You could do it by clicking that little icon down there or the red box below. Give this video a thumbs up. I would really appreciate it. I love you guys. See you in the next one.